The Webhook Block allows you to send data collected in a bot to external apps or servers, or bring data from outside sources to the bot. In this video, we'll help you understand what the Webhook Block is capable of doing in Landbot. Keep in mind that it's a feature for more advanced users. The Webhook Block is fully capable for channels like WhatsApp, Messenger, API chatbots, and web chatbots. So let's understand how to use it with an example. We will build a very simple WhatsApp chatbot from scratch that asks for the name and email. It then sends that information to HubSpot, a quite popular CRM, to create a contact there. After that, on the same flow, we will ask for the company name and, using another webhook block, update the contact information of that same user. Consider that, with this example, we're focusing on the webhooks block and not so much on the overall bot's conversation. For that, there are a set of steps we will follow. First, we'll create the bot with its basic questions. Then, in the HubSpot API documentation, we'll copy the code we need in order to create a contact. Thirdly, we'll use Postman, an application used for API testing, that will dissect the code and simplify the next process. That will be setting up and testing the webhook block in Landbot. Keep in mind, every API is different, but this workflow using Postman is usually a great approach when starting out with the webhook block in Landbot. So let's get started. Let's go and click on Build a Chatbot. Select WhatsApp and start from scratch. We will keep the flow simple since we're focusing here on the webhook block. I'll just change a couple of things to the welcome message. Now, I'll add a question name block with its respective variable associated with it. After that, a question email block, and same here with the variable. We need to capture it. Great. So now we're capturing these two questions in the respective variables. Now, we want to send this information to HubSpot and create a contact there. For that, we'll follow the flow with a webhook block. Great. Now what? Well, we can just start writing and filling up all of these parameters. We have to know exactly what we want and what we need. As I mentioned before, we want to create a contact in HubSpot. So let's go to HubSpot's developers documentation. Searching in developers documentation is where you'll probably spend most of your time. I've done my research before doing this video, so I already know where to find it. So, here, as you can see, is the section to create a contact. Here you can find its information and parameters. We're interested here in the request, specifically in the CURL. The CURL actually stands for client URL. It's used to transfer data to and from a server, which is exactly what we're doing. So I'll copy this code and head to Postman. Postman is a very useful tool since it simplifies even more each step. We recommend using it. Just like with HubSpot, creating an account in Postman is free. Once inside, head to Workspaces and My Workspace. Here, I'll click on Import. We want to import the code we just copied in HubSpot. Click on Raw Text and paste it there. Continue and import. Now, you might have noticed, maybe not, but we're starting to see some similarities here to Landbot. Things like the URL, words like params, headers, body. And that's what's great with Postman. It separates all the important information for you to copy and paste in Landbot. First of all, let's start with the URL. Copy it and paste it here. Make sure it's set to post. Now, let's move on to params. Params are information that will be added to the URL. As you can see, when I type here something, it's added up in the URL in green. In this case, we would have to add the happy key. But if you look closely, it's already added in the URL we copied. So we don't need to do that. What we need to do instead is find the unique API key in HubSpot. So let's head back to HubSpot. Not to the developer's documentation, but to our actual account, which is free to create one. Go to Settings, Integrations, and API key. If it's your first time, it will tell you to create one. I already have this one. Make sure to copy it and paste it back in Landbot, replacing the text. Great, but we're not done yet with the block. Let's head back to Postman. On headers, we need to copy and paste the key, which is content type. And its value, which is application/json. For the body, copy this code and paste it in Landbot, where it says customize body. Now, we need to change this body since this one doesn't make much sense to our use case. We are sending name and email, nothing more. So let's delete the things we don't need. Now, delete the values and type down the corresponding variables from Landbot. Make sure that they are between quotation marks. All right, so this webhook is set. We just need to test it to make sure it actually works. To test it, add some random test variables here. And click on test the request. Great, so if the status code is a number around the 200s, we're good to go. If we go to contacts in HubSpot and refresh the site, the contact has been created. Nice. Now, let's move on to how to update this contact created. In order to update a contact, we need an ID that verifies that we're actually updating the correct contact. Usually, the ID is a number. As you can see in the test the response body, the first thing we see is the ID and a number that HubSpot sent us. We need to store that number. To do so, go to Save Responses as Variables. Here, I'll type the name HubSpot ID in the string format. And up here, choose from the response body the ID. This way, it's saved inside the variable called HubSpot ID inside Landbot. Okay, we now have that. Let's put the bot on full screen. We'll later use Postman. So let's add a text question block asking for the company name. With its respective variable to store the answer by the user. And after, another webhook block. Same approach as before, in order to set up the webhook that will update the contact, we need to go to the developer's documentation in HubSpot and look for the correct endpoint. In this case, update. Copy the CURL code and do the same as before. Go to Postman and import the code there. Click on import, raw text, paste it there, and import. Let's put Postman and Landbot side by side like before. It's easier to copy. So let's start copying the URL in Postman and paste it in Landbot. Notice that now it's patch and not post like before. Let's also put the API key. I'll copy it from the previous webhook block since it's the same. Also, since we're updating a contact, it's essential to add the HubSpot user ID in the URL, right before the question mark, like it says in the developer's documentation. Now I'll speed up the copying process from Postman. For the body, we just want to update the company name. So we delete all the others and add the variable, like we did before. Now, let's test it. Let's add a random company name. And for the HubSpot ID, if you want to update the previous created contact, we need to know its number ID. I don't remember the number, so I'll check in HubSpot. If you click on the contact, up in the URL should be the ID value we are looking for. Copy it and paste it here. Great. Click on test and awesome, 200. Now, if we head back to HubSpot and refresh, we will see that the contact has NASA as company name. Cool. And we're done. If you actually watched all the way here, you're a champ. Let's now have some fun and actually test it on our phone as if we were the end user. For that, we'll need to link this bot with a WhatsApp testing channel. Let me quickly do that. All right, now to test it, you could do it with WhatsApp Web, but I prefer using my phone. So I'll scan the QR code. Here, firstly, I'll type my name, email, and now, if we actually head to HubSpot and refresh the contact site, we will see it there without the company name. So on my phone, let's now type the company name and refresh again the contact page in HubSpot. And as you can see, it now has the company name I just typed. So we are done. Hope this video helped you understand how to actually use the Webhook Block. To recap, we built a WhatsApp bot from scratch with some basic questions, so that with a Webhook Block, we can send all that information to HubSpot. For that, we went to the HubSpot documentation, copied some code there, and pasted it in Postman. Postman then dissected the code to copy it easily back to Landbot. Once the webhook to create a contact was done, we moved to updating the contact in HubSpot on that same user. As you may have seen, it's not an easy process, but the possibilities that you get to integrate with so many APIs is something worth trying. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell to keep up to date with all this type of content. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you around.